Hi, so you have decided to go for a postdoc. Congratulations. I think it's a great decision and hopefully it's the right one for you. So a question that often comes up is, when should I be planning for this postdoc? When should I be writing letters of inquiry? And when should I be sending out applications? And this is what we're going to deal with right now. Now, in picking a postdoc, of course, there's many decisions to take and they're important, and I deal with them in other videos. So if you're interested in that, please check there. Here, it's just about the time frame and the timing, to get the timing right when to send out this letter of inquiry and the applications. Because I think there is like a sweet spot, there is a more optimal time window when you should do that, which means you can be too early and you can be too late. Now, being too late, I think, is more immediately obvious, and we're going to talk about that after this, but being too early maybe is a little bit counterintuitive. Like, how could you possibly be too early? Now, let me explain that. So let's say you are relatively early in your PhD and you start sending a letter of inquiry to a potential postdoc lab and say, like, here I am, I find what you do cool, can we talk about a potential postdoc? Now, if they then see, or if you write, well, I still have a year and a half to go in my PhD, then this is not necessarily working to your advantage. I mean, because you can just drop off the radar, because people are not going to be constantly reminding themselves of you being out there and waiting for you to graduate. Is not how it typically works, right? So, I mean, people have a limited attention span, and you could just drop off the radar if you sent this out too early. Now, if you apply for a specific job ad, like, let's say, then you can be too early also in various ways. For example, you send in your application, it turns out you would be a great candidate for whatever reason, but you can only start in another year and a half. And so this could work. I'm not saying this is categorically excluded from being successful, but typically when somebody has a grant funded, they are interested in filling that position pretty fast. In some cases, they even lose money for every month that the position is not filled, right? And it depends on the mode of funding in the country you're at, an institution, but whatever the situation is, you cannot delay for long periods of time when you're actually gonna start. You know, the reasonable expectation is that within a few months, you can actually start. If you're gonna be available then only in a year, or maybe if there's some delays in a year and a half, then this may just not be attractive to the person hiring you, because somebody else can start earlier. And so the end of every interview is actually, when can you actually start? Because that's sometimes super important, especially when the start date from the project that somebody has is not negotiable, then of course it's super important. But generally also people just want to get started with stuff. Now, another way in which this can work against you is, like, in some institutions in some countries, like, for example, in our case, if you apply for a postdoc job, but you don't have your PhD diploma, you don't have your final exam or whatever the criterion is, it varies from state to state, you actually cannot be even considered for that position. So then basically it's just wasted time basically applying for this. So if you're unsure about that, you can just ask in a letter if you can actually apply, understanding that you don't have your diploma yet. Well, this can still work in your favor, because once they've seen your file, maybe they're gonna save you away basically for another opportunity in the future. Or maybe if they couldn't fill the position, they're gonna re-advertise and they know about you. So I'm not saying this is just definitively a disadvantage, but in this case, it was too early to be considered for this particular employment opportunity. So you can see there's a bunch of situations where this may not be advantageous to go for a letter of inquiry or a job application too early. And the last one is actually one that is also important, because when you are just 1.5 years or maybe 2 years into your PhD and you still have maybe a year and a half to go, or however long your PhD is in the country that you're from, then your CV is maybe not as strong as it could be if you had waited maybe another half a year or a year. I see that fairly often, actually. So then, well, it may still work to your advantage if there is some name recognition when you come again later and say, like, oh yeah, this was XYZ, has already voiced an interest in coming here. Okay, maybe serious about it, things like that. But generally speaking, when you at least wait until you have some preprints out, let's say, or some chapters are written and they're in manuscript form, and it basically got something to show, then I think it's much better that you start shopping around and send letters of inquiry then when you do that too early and you really leave people guessing as to what you have actually going to accomplish, what you're actually going to accomplish in the future and what you have already accomplished now. Now, I think this is being too early. I think being too late is much more obvious. So for example, well, you could have just missed a deadline for something. Fellowships, for example, for postdocs, they come typically with deadlines. Not all of them have deadlines, but many of them have deadlines or target dates that are coming around maybe only once or sometimes twice a year. So if you just missed that deadline, then you were too late because you may have to wait another whole cycle of a year to apply again. Or also if just maybe 3 months ago before you started looking more seriously for jobs, there was the perfect job opportunity that became open, but it's now already been filled because, well, you weren't on the market back then. This happens. But I think it's immediately clear to everybody how you can be actually too late. Basically, this means if you want a seamless transition in terms of not having extended periods of time off between your PhD and your postdoc, then you really need to get on the ball and don't wait until the very end. This can still work out, of course. You can get lucky, and many people are. It's like this, they just graduated, just the perfect job comes rolling around or is already waiting for them or whatever. This can, of course, happen, but I wouldn't leave that up to chance and move to a time window that's more favorable for your success. Now, if you are interested in funding your PhD by writing, for example, a grant or by a fellowship application that requires you to have a project description, basically a project outline or even a full proposal, basically, then you need to consider that that takes time. You know, this takes at least, unless you've done it before successfully, a couple of months. And then you have to add on to that the evaluation period. You know, I mean, sometimes for fellowships, you wait 6 to 8 months to hear back for postdoctoral fellowships. Or if you submit a grant proposal to, so let's say, a federal agency, or if you write a grant proposal that somebody submits to you for a federal agency, this can also be 6 months or something, or sometimes longer, until you hear back. And so if this is your mode in which you're going to seek funding for your postdoc, you can really be too late if you wait until the very end, because that means, you know, all this time is now ticking away after you've already gotten your PhD. So what is then an ideal time window to start looking for a job and for sending letters of inquiry? I think it's about 5 to 6 months. I think 5 to 6 months is a reasonable time window when, you know, you're going to be just a few months after they've made a decision to hire you, for example, when you would actually be available. So it's totally reasonable. Everybody can wait that long. I mean, this is never going to be this firm, and you can always negotiate a start date like that. So I think this is a good time window. It also allows you to go through a couple of iterations, apply for a couple of jobs, send a couple of letters of inquiry. Sometimes these processes also take time. So I think 5 to 6 months is definitely when you should be starting to do this. But you need to start earlier if you're going for the mode of like writing a grant proposal or writing a fellowship application. You need to move this all up front, right? Because it takes so long to evaluate these things if you want to have the seamless transition to a postdoc. So the bottom line is, in your last year, let's say, you need to ideally know you're going to go for a postdoc and have some start, make some plans on where this is going to be, by what mode is going to be funded, and what are you going to do? Are you going to wait like a couple more months to send out letters of inquiry? Or, you know, basically that last month you need to dedicate, in part, of course, to this postdoc search. Now, this is easier said than done, right? Because the end of your PhD is going to be a stressful period anyway, probably the most period. Well, the beginning is also very difficult, but the end is going to be like packed with thesis writing and defenses and all kinds of these things. It's already stressful, so you need to be careful that you don't overload yourself with piling that on top of everything as well. This is why it's so important to start early and leave yourself a reasonable time window. You know, you may start sending out letters of inquiry in earnest, maybe 5-6 months or so before you graduate, but start earlier to think about what you want, and maybe never forget the networking, right? The networking you can, of course, always do from day one of your PhD. So you have a professional network. You have a layout of who is who in your particular field. You follow them on Twitter, or you meet them at conferences and you know what's going on. You may also find out about opportunities this way if you have networked before. And if you want to find out more about network and how to do it and for what reason, I have a video about that. So if you're interested in that, feel free to check that out. So, I mean, this is important though to say that this last year where you're going to be devoting some of your time at least to checking out what are the opportunities for postdocs, it's going to be much easier on you if you've early on already invested the time in some good networking. So good luck with getting this all sorted, and I hope you get the postdoc of your dreams. And with that, thanks very much for watching, and see you in the next video.